नमस्ते, मैं सर त्रिवेणी खुराना, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, फैकल्टी ऑफ फिजियोथेरेपी एंड डायग्नोस्टिक्स। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट इक्विलिब्रियम। व्हाट इज इक्विलिब्रियम? इट इज एबिलिटी टू मेंटेन ओरिएंटेशन ऑफ द बॉडी एंड इट्स पार्ट इन रिलेशन टू एक्सटर्नल स्पेस एंड इट डिपेंड्स ऑन कंटिन्यूस inputs from visual, labyrinthine and proprioception, and it is associated with brainstem and cerebellum. Normally, we are unaware of these adjustments because they operate largely at a reflex level. If equilibrium disturbs, it results in spatial orientation system disorders. And its important symptoms include, first is vertigo, which is due to the dysfunction of vestibular system, and in this patient feels unusual movements, which may include rotating, spinning, whirling, oscillating, rocking, tilting and swaying. The next symptom is ataxia, which includes unsteadiness, imbalance, falling to one side, incoordination, wearing a new pair of eyeglass feelings, and this ataxia is due to the dysfunction of sensory, cerebellar and vestibular pathways. And the third symptom is near syncope, which may include lightheadedness, fainting, giddiness, passing out, candle being slowly exhausted. If with loss of consciousness, syncope may occur, and this is due to disturbed blood flow to the brain, or we can say that global cerebral ischemia. And the fourth symptom is pseudo vertigo, including feeling low, weakness, fatigue, or feeling of unreality, which is totally based on psychological issues. Now, how can we treat these balance or equilibrium disturbances by activities such as stabilization exercises of the proximal and trunk muscles, by mat activities using PNF techniques to establish static and dynamic stability in neurodevelopmental positions, by training the patient to assume different postures, and to train in various postures such as onto the forearms, from lying down to crawl, to come onto the knees, half knees, and into a sitting position. Then the patient should be taught how to maintain the required position for static stability by approximation and verbal directions. Strengthen static stability through external perturbations by pushing or pulling in different directions. Afterwards, the patient should be trained in these positions for weight transference and functional extension, so as to prepare for dynamic stabilization. Subsequently, the patient should be trained in positions in which support surface is narrowed or center of gravity is changed in order to make the balance activities difficult. Example, establishing balance on two or three extremities in the crawling position, or shifting the center of gravity upwards by elevation of the arm in sitting on the knee position. Next activity we have balance in the standing position. In this, weight transference to the front, back and sides, narrowing the support surface, balance training in tandem position, balance training on one leg. Next training we have balance training on posturography device, which is another option in order to benefit from visual feedback obtained from observing the patient's ability to sustain his postural oscillation in the center of gravity. Gait training is also a good method for equilibrium activities. This is the best indicator of dynamic stabilization. Walking on the narrow line, tandem gait, backward gait, slow down gait, stopping and turning, response to certain directions, flexion, extension and left-right rotations of the head included in gait training. Next option we have yoga and tai chi too. Other than these, we have Frankel's exercises. What is Frankel exercise? Before going to Frankel exercise, we are going to discuss about history. It is developed by Dr. H.S. Frankel for the condition Tibis dorsalis. Tibis dorsalis patient whose prominent symptom was ataxia. Dr. H.S. Frankel was a medical superintendent of the Centurion Framework in Switzerland towards the end of the last century. Since then, this method has been used to treat the equilibrium disorders, which results from many other diseases such as disseminated sclerosis. Treatment program that consists of systematic and graduated exercises applied for the lower limb, and it is designed to overcome incoordination, poor balance and proprioception loss by visual feedback. Exercises are designed primarily for incoordination, which is an alternative method of control. They are not intended for strengthening. I repeat, Frankel's exercises are not intended for strengthening. Frankel exercises, this a process of motor learning similar to that required to learn any new exercise, and the essential being are concentration of attention, precision and repetition. Now, what are the various goals of Frankel's exercises? General or ultimate goal of the exercises are, it enables the patient to carry out activities that are essential for independence in his everyday life. It compensates for the loss of proprioceptive and kinesthetic sensation, which is inability to tell where the limb are in space without looking. Via establishment of voluntary control of movement by the use of any part of the sensory mechanism which remain intact, notably sight, sound and touch. Now, the technique for Frankel exercise. The patient is positioned and suitably clothed so that he can see the limbs throughout the exercise. It is important that the area is well lit and that the patient is positioned so that he can watch the movement of his limb during exercise. A concise explanation and demonstration of exercise is given before movement is attempted. To give the patient clear mental picture of exercises, command should be given in even slow voice. The exercise should be done to counting. Speed of movement is detected by the therapist, and by means of rhythmic counting, movement of her hand and use of suitable music. The patient must give his full attention to the performance of the exercise to make the movement smooth and accurate. Exercises should be done within the normal range of motion to avoid overstretching of muscles. The range of movement is indicated by marking the spot on which the foot or hand is to be placed. The first simple exercises should be adequately performed before progressing to more difficult patterns. The exercise must be repeated many times until it is adequately and easily performed. It is then discarded and more difficult one is substituted. Avoid fatigue as these exercises are very tiring at first. Frequent rest period must be allowed. The patient retains little or no ability to recognize fatigue, but it is usually indicated by deterioration in the quality of movement or by rise in the pulse rate. Perform each exercise not more than 4 times. I repeat, perform Frankel exercises not more than 4 times. Rest between each exercise. The exercise routine takes about half an hour and should be done 2 times daily. Now, what should be the progression for the Frankel exercise? It can be achieved by alternating speed, altering range, and altering complexity of the exercise. First, we are going to see speed. Start with fast and then with the slow movements. Quick movements require less control than the slow ones. Later on, alteration in the speed of conservative movement and interruption, which involves stopping and starting to command, are introduced. Range of motion, it starts by proximal, then by the distal joints. Wide range and primitive movements in which large joints are used gradually give way to those involving the use of small joints, limited range, and more frequent alteration of direction. Complexity of exercise, simple before complex. Remember, simple exercises before complex exercises. Simple movements are built up into sequence to form specific action which require the use and control of number of joints and more than one limb. Example in walking. What are the various examples of Frankel's exercise? We have half lying. In half lying, hip and knee flexion and extension of each limb, foot flat on the plinth. Second exercise in half lying, hip adduction and abduction on each limb with the foot flat, knee flexed, then with knee extended. Third exercise in half lying, hip and knee flexion and extension of each limb, heel lifted off the plinth. Fourth exercise in half lying is heel one limb to opposite leg. Fifth exercise in half lying is heel of one limb to opposite knee, sliding down crest of tibia up to ankle. Sixth exercise in half lying is hip and knee flexion and extension of both limbs, legs together. Seventh exercise in half lying is reciprocal movements of both limbs, flexion of one leg during extension of the other. Now, Frankel exercise in sitting position. The first exercise in sitting position is knee flexion and extension of each limb, which progress to marking time. Second exercise in sitting is hip abduction and adduction. Third exercise in sitting is alternate foot placing to specified target by using floor marks. Fourth exercise in sitting is standing up and sitting down to a specified count. Now, next Frankel exercise is in standing position. In this, first exercise is foot placing to a specified target, which is marked by floor mark. Second exercise in standing is weight shifting. Now, walking, in this, sideways or forward to a specified count. Second exercise in walking is turning around to a specific count. Now, exercising for legs in the lying position, in which starting position should be lying on the bed or couch with a smooth surface along which the feet can be moved easily. Head should be raised on a pillow so that the patient can see every movement. As I said above, in this hip adduction and abduction, the leg is fully supported throughout on the smooth surface on the plinth or on a re-education board. Second exercise was, as I said above, is one hip and knee flexion and extension. The heel is supported throughout and slides on the plinth to its position indicated by the therapist. One leg raising top and ace heel on the specified mark. The mark may be made on the plinth, on the patient, or the foot or shin, or the heel may be placed in the palm of the therapist's hand. Fourth exercise is hip and knee flexion and extension, abduction and adduction. The legs may work alternately or in the opposite to each other. Stopping and starting to intercourse of movement may be introduced to increase the control required to perform any of these exercises. Now, we have exercises, Frankel exercises for arms. Various coordination boards may be used to improve eye-hand coordination. It can also use a blackboard and chalk. Change a minus sign to a plus sign. Copy simple diagrams such as circles, zigzag lines, straight lines. These exercises is done in various positions such as in sitting. In this, first exercise should be shoulder flexion or extension. Place hand on a specified mark. Second exercise in sitting is one arm stretching to thread it through a small hoop or ring. Third exercise in sitting is picking up objects and putting them down. Next exercise, arm swing forward and backward in standing and walking to bounce and catch or throw and catch a ball in standing or walking. Thank you.